What's up, vinyl community and music fans? Today's episode is dedicated to some random back catalog picks out of my collection, so stick around to see what kind of surprises I have in store for you. Thanks for sticking around. I hope everybody's staying safe. I hope you're following your government's guidelines in this day and age. It's crazy times right now, and all the more reason to chill out to some really good music right now too. So for starters, here's one of my all-time favorite records.
Did you ever think what music would sound like underwater?
This album exemplifies that. My first random pick today is Sven Liebeck's Inner Space soundtrack. This came out in 1973 and it was a soundtrack to an underwater documentary on Australian TV. It features many of Australia's session musicians, jazz musicians, and it's phenomenal. It really feels like you're underwater when you hear this, and it's so soothing and relaxing at the same time. And I've heard this called aquatic jazz exotica. To me, this is just gorgeous stuff. So Sven Liebeck was born in Norway and moved to Australia in his early 20s. He's a graduate of the Juilliard School of Arts in New York City, and he had many different positions related to music throughout the years. Among some of those jobs was a musical director at CBS Records and A&R guy. He's also general manager for a music publishing company. So Sven later left CBS to work as a freelance composer, arranger, conductor, and he established his own music production company. Another fun fact is he composed scores for some of the Hanna-Barbera cartoons. So far I have 8 records roughly from Sven Liebeck and Sven Liebeck and his orchestra, and this is by far my favorite. So I've got 2 versions of this one here, and then there's another one where William Shatner did the narration actually for this documentary, and this version here contains the narration with William, and this one here is just the music straight up. Fun fact as well, this was in a Wes Anderson film, The Life of the Aquatic something or other. Anyway, there's about 4 songs taken from this and put in that movie too. Anyway, there's nothing like this. Votary Records released this. There's actually a reissue that's out right now. So highly recommended.
Check it out.
So next up is a record by Honey. So Honey is actually DJ Johan Cederberg, and he's got quite a few 12 inches out there. I think this is his only full length. It's called Sunday. Really amazing stuff. So some of Honey's influences are De La Soul, Tribe Called Quest, Fortet, Caribou, and composer Steve Reich. So his influences are pretty sweet. This reminds me a little bit at times of Bonobo, not always though. He's also done remixes for Mariah Carey, Moon Boots, Flight Facilities, who I love, and many others. So this is a really chill, down-tempo, smooth, relaxing album. So if you just want something to put on and just chill out to, especially in this day and age, highly recommended, Honey, Sunday. Next is one of my favorite Canadian rock bands, alternative bands, Metric. Fantasies. This album is phenomenal. If you don't already know Metric, and I'd be surprised, they are a band from Toronto who formed in 1998. So Fantasies came out in 2009, their fourth album, and in 2010 it won the Alternative Album of the Year at the Junos, which is pretty much the Canadian equivalent of the Grammys. And that year they also won Group of the Year. Every song on this album is stellar. It's such a great album through and through. So I've seen them live twice now and they are so infectious live, just amazing. They've had quite a few albums over the years and to me this is the standout album. And also their latest, Art of Doubt, which I've got a special edition of, is really, really good as well. In fact, I saw them twice on that tour for that album. Anyway, Metric Fantasies, check this out. Up next is a group that I just absolutely love, and I'm highly looking forward to future releases from these guys. So the album is called The Dog in the Future, and the group is Agar Agar. Agar Agar? Agar Agar. Agar Agar? You decide. These guys are a very eclectic, experimental, electro-pop group from France. Their names are Clara Capagli and Armand Boutil. Forgive me if I'm mispronouncing that. So the two of them met in art school in Paris. Clara was featured in different songs from a group named Jabberwocky, and she also was in a garage band named Canary Terror. Agar Agar have released two albums, so they have an EP before this, which I just love as well. This truly is electropop at its finest. I just love every song on here, and some of it's really hard to categorize. It's very different. It's a little bit experimental, but it's always interesting. It's quirky, it's off-kilter at times, avant-garde, synthy pop. It's hard to describe, but those are some of the ways that I would describe it, I guess. I got. There are strange lyrics, there are hidden messages in the lyrics. One of the standouts to me are the vocals. Clara has such an amazing voice. Her voice is beautiful, it's raspy, it's got this little raspiness to it. Her voice is sexy at times, it's angelic at times. If you truly want to listen to something fearless with no boundaries, really good electronic music with solid beats, with quirky but infectious vocals, I highly recommend this album. Agar Agar, The Dog in the Future. So good. Last but not least for today, one of my random back catalog picks from my collection is the soundtrack to Vampiros Lesbos. Yes, what a quirky title, I get it. But this was a movie that was released in 1971. This was a West German / Spanish movie, and it was directed and co-written by Jesus Franco, who did a bunch of other films like this little erotica horror type stuff. So the soundtrack was composed and performed by Siegfried Schwab, Mayfred Hubier, and Jesus Franco himself. And the soundtrack actually is a combination of two other records that came out around this time. One of them was called Psychedelic Dance Party and the other one was called Sexadelic. So this is space age pop, exotica, lounge, and psychedelic music all in one. It's so good. In fact, one song off of this was featured in a Quentin Tarantino movie, Jackie Brown, back in the day. So there's a bit of street cred right there. Anyway, I've got two copies of this. I've got the black vinyl version and I've also got a yellow amber version as well. Highly recommended. Here's a dose. Thanks for watching, everybody. Please leave your comments. What do you think of these releases? Please subscribe if you haven't already. Thanks for watching, everybody. I really appreciate it. Stay safe. You've been watching
Death by Records. Vampiros, Despots, Despots, Vampiros, 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 Despots.
'Raspy, raspy, raspy, raspiness.'
So stick around. You might see something that tickles your fancy.
Thought.
My first random pick for today is Sven Li... My first random pick for today is Sven...
'Raspy, raspy, raspy, raspiness.'
Bonobo. Not always, though.
Bonobo. Not always, though.
Bonobo. Not always, though. Highly recommended, Hyundai.
Raspy, 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 raspiness, thought.